Hello, Al Karitz here. I'm the application and service manager for Electron Microscopy Sciences. Today I'm going to be showing you how to set up and operate the mini sputter coater that we offer, the SC7620. Okay, so here's the SC7620. It is a somewhat primitive sputter coater, but sometimes people just sputtering gold palladium or silver, this is all they really need. This is like 1990s technology. It's completely manually sort of operated, and I'll show you how this all works as we go along. First, let's have a look at the back of the unit. We have the mains cord, which gets plugged into an outlet. We have the on-off switch. We have two fuses, which we hope we never have to change, but that's a different topic. We have the output for plugging the rotary pump in, so it's connected in sync with the unit. We have the 10KF vacuum fitting on the back of the chamber for pump out, and we have a orifice to introduce argon, which is the carrier gas for the sputter process. All right, I went ahead and I connected everything up, put oil in the rotary pump. This is the fill port for that. Put on the exhaust filter, plug this into the back of the coater, made sure that we'll have to check here in a moment if the on-off switch is actually in the on position. So let's have a look inside the chamber and let me show you how to install the target. That seems to cause a great deal of confusion. It's always good to wear gloves so you don't put your fingerprints all over the inside of the chamber, which slows the pumping sequence. It's also very good to make sure that the O-ring here and the O-ring here is dust and dirt free. This is the stage height plate. Like I said, this is a very simple unit. You just raise and lower it to the desired distance from the specimen to the target. The system will not allow use of a film thickness monitor. Like I said, it's a very basic system. So where the confusion begins is here on the sputter head. As you can see, there's two hex head screws to remove. They're 2.5 millimeters. You take them out. And you remove the entire shield, which is known as the dark space shield. This is the tricky part. And for some reason in the instructions, it's not clear. There is a screw-on retaining ring which needs to be unscrewed and loosened. Your target, in this case I'm using gold. I'm not going to sputter with gold because I don't want to dirty up the system, but you drop the gold target inside here and then this screws back on. Just snug it down, then replace the dark space ring using the hex head screwdriver and you're set to go. So that's the correct installation of targets in the 7620. If you need to change the target, you just go through the same exact procedure. Once the target's installed, and you've attached argon gas, you're essentially good to go. You can put the glass cylinder back in place, put your sample inside, and close the lid. Okay, so the target's installed. We have argon gas. The rotary pump is connected. So now we'll power it on. We have the vacuum meter here. We have the sputter current analog gauge here. Start pump will start the whole operation, which I'll demonstrate in a moment. Set plasma, where you can adjust the sputter pressure to attain the sputter current you desire. Start press process starts the countdown timer to shut off. There is no shutter in this system because it's so simple. So your sample is going to get coated from the moment you light a plasma to the moment you turn it off. Over here we have the option of sputtering or glow discharge. So I'm going to select sputter. Glow discharge is sort of a mild plasma cleaning process, mostly used to allow carbon-coated grids to become hydrophilic. We won't get into that too much. Here we have the vent valve and we have a leak valve. The vent valve is when you want to vent the system at the end of the process after the rotary pump is turned off. The leak valve allows you to set the sputter current. So let's start it pumping. It may be a little difficult to hear, but there's some clicks that you can hear when the rotary pump is not on the same level as the system. These are safety interlocks engaging, allowing the sputter process to occur. Now, usually what I like to do is, during the pumping process, is I like to flush the chamber a few times before lighting a plasma. This is to drive out water vapor which is clinging to the inside, any outgassing of the chamber. This usually will improve the vacuum quite rapidly. So I open the leak valve, let it flow for a few seconds, and then close the leak valve. Now, might I add, you can easily over tighten the leak valve and the vent valve, causing you to have to replace the valve. These are delicate. It's not necessary to use a wrench on them, just finger tight. Okay, so you can see the vacuum has improved. Because we're working with a rotary pump system, through a tube into a chamber, you really won't expect it to really exceed the 10 to the minus 2 millibar range. But at any rate, this is a good enough vacuum to work with. However, I am going to purge just one more time. I might also add that the vacuum gauge is not calibrated to read argon. So you might have an error in reading when you vent the system, because you're going to vent it with argon gas. It still might give you like a reading where you have vacuum left in the chamber when you really don't. Okay, so the next step we're going to do is we're going to set plasma. And I removed the target because, as I explained, I don't want a sputter in this chamber. This is sort of a show unit, display unit, not an actual working unit here in the laboratory on a daily basis. We use much more sophisticated systems. So in order to get the system to sputter, you need to increase the argon gas pressure in the chamber little bit. And we'll set it around 0.6 or 0.7. It will take a little bit of time to get used to that. We will press the set plasma button. We have a weak plasma. And now we can adjust the gas flow. Less gas, lower current. Higher gas, higher current. The higher the current, the faster the sputter rate is. So we'll just set it to 15. And once it's at 15, we can hit start process, and it will maintain the sputtering for whatever value you have set on the timer. This case, I think 60 seconds. This is not a press the button and walk away system. You might have to play with the valve here a little bit and adjust the current so it's constant. With this system being a very primitive coder, you will get some variability in your coding. This is just due to the nature of the system. With the more advanced Q-series coders, this process is computer controlled, thus highly accurate. So at the end of the time, the sputtering is terminated, and then you can press the start pump button and open the vent valve and completely vent the chamber, and it opens like that. Then you gently close the leak valve, take your samples out, and go observe them in the SEM. So this is the 7620 sputter coder, mini sputter coder. These are the basic operation and setup principles involved with this instrument. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me at Electron Microscopy Sciences, and I can answer those questions for you. Thanks very much for your attention.